we are open for queries. So we will pick up the queries from the participants which has typed during this session. One of the participants has raised the compatibility issues. As you know that when you look in each manufacturer's website, they have clearly defined various series, and you could compare it based on the speed it supported. That's one of the criteria which you can use. For example, when you're looking at Tourney 3x8 speed component, you could probably look the 3x8 speed components from the other manufacturer range, and then you can make a comparison on your own.
Pradeep,
yeah,
can you hear me? You're answering questions. Can we do the question answer according to the series that we will please tell the
sure.
name? So we'll go one by one from the time they have typed it.
Sure. And this the query we answered is raised by Mr. Anandakrishnan. And then okay. We have a query on from Mr. Gopesh on the bicycle geometry.
We'll start from one to one. Can I just moderate on this at least?
Sure.
So that we can also give credits to those people who has participated and been on questioning.
Yeah.
Octavia wants some tea and biscuits, of course. He is in Goa, I think. He will get beer and sausages, not tea and biscuits. So he will be happy on that. Sahil Sharma, can we add and customize with these components? Sahil Sharma has asked, can we add and customize these components? Pradeep, are you seeing this?
Yes. So as you know that we have given you the websites, links for various manufacturers, and you could mix and match these various components. Say, for example, you could have a Shimano 105 shifters, and you could use Microshift shifters, which belongs to equivalent of Altigra. So basically, you need to see your component specifications and the matching component specifications. Say, for example, if you are replacing Shimano, probably you could see the spec of your particular Shimano component and see the desired manufacturer's spec. And when it matches, you can reuse it. So like that, you can mix it. And if you want to mix afresh and make own fully customized, probably you can see the manufacturer manual and choose the component, because it would have given the details on maximum speed supported, maximum teeth supported. There are various other metrics you need to see, the like number of teeth, gauge, and there is a relationship between the number of teeth on your cassette and the number of teeth on your crankset. So all these are connected.
The second question, next question, and also for Sahil Sharma, it also requires your requirement, what kind of a ride you are looking at it. Pradeep, isn't that correct?
So when you yes, that is also very critical, because yes. When you use, say, for example, if you are a novice rider who just want to ride quite long, and probably you are riding on a road bike, no point in using a Duraise components, because you may be riding about thousands of kilometers, and Duraise components is supposed to give a better performance, a shorter life, because it's used typically on the high-end performance range category. So that is the yeah.
Thank you, Sahil. I think you got your answer. Next is Gopesh Devnath. Why chromoly steel bikes are so costly? Is that wise to buy these cycles?
Okay. When we see the bicycles, as you know that bicycle has different materials, and one example we give is spokes. When you see many of the manufacturer bicycle spoke specification, they have given steel spokes. And as you know that steel is just an alloy, and steel is different and stainless steel is different. But the layman's perspective is that the steel won't rust, but technically steel and the stainless steel are different. Steel is less expensive, stainless steel are more expensive. That's why spokes, you find manufacturers specifying stainless steel spokes or steel spokes. Both are two different components. So when you, as you know that now the difference between steel and stainless steel, now we come back to the chromoly steel. So basically steel, bicycle frame material has steel, which is typically the your basic steel, which is manufactured widely in India. And then we have another component called high-tension steel, which may be as light as alloy, which you may not see much bikes using heightened steel frames, which is manufactured in India, because very few manufacturers makes this heightened steel, or on a mass scale, this bicycle tubing is not produced in the heightened steel. And then comes the chromoly steel, which is a typically alloy, and it's very widely used in automobile industry and aviation. And this is very lightweight, and which has a characteristic similar to that of carbon. Very lightweight and very long lasting and zero rust. So that's why chromoly as a material is more expensive, and material is more expensive that in turn translate to your bike as well.
So the question had two parts, which why the chromoly steel bikes are so costly. So that you have answered.
Yeah.
Probably and the manufacturing of these bicycles are not in a mass production scale also, correct? So that's one of the reasons.
Yes.
Okay. Second, it is wise to buy these cycles. So that is another question.
As we mentioned earlier, you need to see what the purpose for which you are buying your bicycle, and you have a bicycle budget which you might be having, and then you have a clearly defined purpose. Like say, you are going for a commuting, or you are going for a professional racing, and based on this, you need to find a balance between your cost, your use, and then your performance. Just because you have a financial capacity doesn't mean that you need to buy a bicycle with the top-notch range component, because that may bring you a lot of maintenance because you are using a competition range component on the daily commuting. So you have to first define what purpose for which you are buying the bicycle, what the lifespan you are looking at the components for these bicycles, and then you have to decide. And you need to also keep in mind that the very basic components, especially when you see Tourney has TZ, TY, TX, and Tourney. And TX being the topmost range of the Tourney. TX may last much longer as good as your Altus, but TZ, TY, and the normal Shimano Tourney may not last as that much longer. So when you make decisions, you have to decide accordingly. And also one more thing you have to remember is that always replacements costs are very higher. That's like when you make a bike or decide a bike, you have to wisely select based on all these parameters. Next time when you go for upgrade or replacement, there is a big cost which you may end up paying. So a clear decision based on your purpose, cost, and various other parameters keeping in mind is critical.
Well, thank you very much, Pradeep. Now, there are many questions coming up, already 20 questions. So just I was going through the questions. Some of them are interesting. But now there is Aditya Kulkarni who's asking, can we get this PPT? Aditya, I would tell you one thing. This is a product which Pradeep created. What you can do, in fact, is that you can take screenshots of the screen when Pradeep is showing on the screen. Because we keep on changing the information in this PPT and as we will use it. So you can very well take a screenshot of it so that you won't forget which websites we have told you. That way you can use it. Otherwise, if you want to do it for some other purposes, you can directly contact Pradeep for that matter.
Yeah. And one more information to the participants. As you know that this much information on components, no brands or nobody will give you, because as we design our own product, we have put in that much effort to know each and every macro level components and how it performs, how its efficiency, all these parameters. We have done enough research. That's why we wanted to share some of our learnings to the participants and the riding community.
Thank you, Pradeep. Yep. Abhishek Kashyap, in road bike, how shall we say the group set speed as it is 2x10 or 2x11?
Abhishek, as you know that there are different group sets, like say, for example, Tiagra, the latest Tiagra, I guess it comes with 2x11 and probably 4700. Shazil, you want to address this point or?
No. I was just thinking how it is. You can discuss it.
Okay. So latest Tiagra series is 2x11 and probably 4 years back, Tiagra series is 2x10 and 5 years back, it's 2x9. So you can always say the series like Shimano, Tiagra, part number. And if you want to add to the speed number, you can mention in brackets like 2x10 or 2x11 based on the speed it supported. So you need to clearly see Shimano component brand name, then the series, and then the part number. Then you need to identify which speed it supports. as for example Tiagra or 105. Tiagra is one classic example. Earlier Tiagra used to come in 2x9, 3x9, then it came to 2x10, 3x10, and the latest Tiagra comes in 2x11. And I'm not sure 3x11 is supported, but 2x11 is the latest. So need to see the demand spec.
Yeah. Probably, so for example, if there is a bicycle and then Abhishek want to tell that this is the bicycle, say it is Shimano, Tiagra, how would he call it? So when he addresses his bike to his friend, he would say Shimano Tiagra 2x10 speed. Is that correct way to say it?
Yes. And we can also add Shimano Tiagra 4700. 2x10 speed.
Okay, difficult. It's not correct to say 20 speed, correct?
That's yes, what? Yes, yes.
It is not correct to say 20 speed or 22 speed or 21 speed. Instead, you should say 2x10 or 2x7 or whatever, correct?
Yes.
Okay. Abhishek, next one is please use some Hindi. Well, dekho bhai, Kerala se bol rahe hum. Hamare Hindi to bahut acha nahi hota. Aur Pradeep, I don't think that we will be able to communicate that much in this particular time in Hindi. Pardon us on that. We will speak to you in maybe some simpler English, but Hindi to mushkil ho sakta hai sabhi kuch logon ke liye. Main bol sakta hu, lekin nahi hai is bare mein batane ke liye.
And really apologize for Abhishek for using more on the English side. Because
then Abhishek was not talking about himself. He can understand. Yeah. Lots of his friends have participated.
Yeah, because I speak Hindi, I am not a native language speaker. So
it won't be very easy.
They may not be the proper usage of respects may not be appropriate if I use that version. So that's the reason I thought stick to English so that the proper respect is maintained for all participants.
So what he can do is Abhishek can talk to us and he can translate that to his friends in Punjabi or in Hindi whenever he has some free time and a bottle of whiskey. That's what he can do. Now let's go to the next one. Aditya Kulkarni, which groupset road bike should I buy for Ironman? This will be my first triathlon. Congratulations on your first effort. But do you have an answer for that, Pradeep?
We already addressed this in two particular questions above. One on the Cromwell bike, which bike to use, which group set to use. So this internally addresses this part.
Okay, so it's also personal, maybe. So let me move to the next. He's also said that it's very informative session. Aditya, thank you very much. Sanjeev Sharma, what is the authentication while one is purchasing Shimano product? Is it duplicate or genuine product?
This part is very critical because as you know that Shimano is a wide popular brand and very respected brand, and probably that's one reason many fake components comes in Shimano. So first thing is like you need to buy from trusted place when you buy the Shimano parts. And the next part is that every Shimano part number has some identifiers in terms of Shimano series part number. If it's genuine, it will definitely match with the Shimano specifications that are mentioned in the website. Or if there is some deviations, maybe there will be some authenticated documents available in the Shimano website or in the internet, which is endorsed by Shimano. And other aspect is like, you may find that if you carefully notice the Shimano wording, you can also identify the difference because many of the copy components comes with Shimano or Shinano. It looks same because many of the words which we actually read, we read just by seeing the appearance. We don't actually go by each spelling word. So for example, when you see a Shimano lookalike word, we might have already read it as Shimano, even though the spelling is not Shimano.
Yeah, so that's right.
Yeah.
So the question is that this is a very typical and also it's a very critical question and also very confusing. The thing is that it is all talking about who sells you the original Shimano. So one thing is that buy from a trusted person, a trusted friend or a shop who deals with the original components. And buying from online, we cannot give you any guarantee. Anybody cannot give you any guarantee because it's up to you and your online purchaser. And as Pradeep said, that in the lower level bicycles look alike brands, so read it carefully. And if you are spending a lots of money on buying a higher end Shimano product, just get your shopkeeper or your friend who is in this business help you to find the right component from a right distributor. That is the only way you can do that.
Now. Yeah. And one more point I want to add is, like, as you know, that Shimano is the largest manufacturer, and Shimano sells its components only to brands or factories or through their retail outlets. So probably if you are buying from a manufacturer, there is a fair chance that you get the components, and also their retail networks, you get the components. And many places Shimano has stopped selling online, especially in Europe. Because of this mix-up of fake and original components. So Shimano periodically releases such press releases in their websites. And as you know, that Shimano do have an office in India as well. Their own direct presence in Bangalore.
Correct. That is, for example, Abhishek in Punjab can help everybody in the north to find this, because he will be the right person to know to get a right Shimano original product, genuine product. Good. And Manish Saini, can you please pick up a typical MTB bike model and explain its group set? Will help us to understand the configuration better with example. Pradeep, we should do a special MTB in a different presentation. What do you think?
Sure. Yeah, we can come up with the next presentation. So we'll definitely MTB, take this. Yeah.
Yeah. Mine is like, I like to see MTB discussed. So Manish, we will work on that and we'll send you a link for it. Thank you very much for that interest. Now then, there is no name, it's a number. So ideally, people, when they join into Zoom, please register with your name, if it's possible. At least write your name in your question so that we know who you are. This is 714D, whatever. Which is better, best series, EZ or Y or X? Come on, that was the one thing. The entire presentation was all about to tell you how to choose a series. So I do not know how Pradeep can give an answer on which best.
So as we've given the Shimano website, and as you know that there is a typical balance between the price versus product, as the series goes up from the very basic to high end, the cost also goes up. So it's just like this. You want to have the best performance like a BMW, but you can't get that BMW performance at the price of Maruti Alto. So every product has its own price and its own performance. So that's like you call it as price versus performance versus product life.
Well, in our future coming presentations, we will be able to give you more insights on things. This is just the presentation which tells you basics, and in 30 minutes or 40 minutes, we could do what we can. So now with these in mind, you can prepare questions and you can keep us sending those. So with that, we can make another presentation and come back to you. Now, the next one question is from Ananda Krishnan. What is shadow technology of Shimano?
It's a typical Shimano technology. So you can explore in the Shimano website. There is a specific page for technology. It has explained all the technologies which are released by Shimano. You could explore on that website, because this itself is a wide topic and which has wide coverage, which cannot be explained over a short minute. So this is a recommended source. You go to Shimano, and in the Shimano website technology section, there Shimano has clearly explained each technologies they have used and released over the various period.
Now the next one, thank you very much. Now Arun Prithviraj, it would be good to share the price comparisons and also the optimum composition recommendations from sale. Okay, price comparisons and optimum composition recommendation. Pradeep, will you work on that?
Definitely, as we said, like there is a balance between the price versus performance. And when you see specifically to this brand, which we mentioned, it's again manufactured by us. And we use optimal performance because we all ride bicycles passionately. And so we ensure that just like our personal bicycle, every rider do get that same personal feel on every bicycle they use of the brand.
Okay. Next is Manish Saini again. And if I have a particular bike model, how do I find out that what kind of upgradation can I do in the same bike group set?
Okay. here you need to
find out. Yeah,
here you need to see every part number associated with your bike. As I said, you might have only looked at the series from the which is appearing on the front end. See the part number and see the Shimano website on what suitable component it can be updated, and then accordingly you can make a decision.
I think that now it's almost time for 11 o'clock. We will have to wind out, and lots of people are signing out also. So quickly, what we'll do is, I would also suggest one thing that this presentation is to give you some insights on the already non-bicycling community, what small things they can get an answer for. But otherwise, you should always be in contact with a good bicycle store and good technician background. People who are learned, who have attended Shimano training courses, various other places. So they will be the one person who can give you suggestions on it. Isn't that correct?
Yeah, Shazil, we have some more queries which we can touch upon similar. Like one is on the cycles which used to be on the Indian roads by Arun Prithviraj. So it's like typically based on the what is your riding pattern and what terrain you would like to explore. It's typically like this MTBs in the cycle space is considered as SUVs, which you can take it to any terrain. So if you have an MTB, you could probably ride on any kind of terrain. And similar counterpart from the road bike is the gravel bicycles, which is very popular now. Gravel bicycle is actually your cyclocross bicycle, which was quite popular in 80s, 90s, which is from the Belgium space. Because in Belgium, Flanders is very common for cyclocross race. And this is a product which evolved from cyclocross, or you could say like it's the same cyclocross getting rebranded as a gravel bike. So MTBs, gravel bikes, probably it's just like SUVs of the modern cycling, which you could use on any road. And as you know that these are typically on the high-end product. So there is a balance between the price and the product. So you need to choose between the price, product, and the spec.
Okay. Pradeep, we have to quickly go to some of the questions and
points
up, because there is some interesting questions. Why carbon frame or cycle are not popular in India? Which is not correct. Sahil Sharma, carbon frame cycles are getting very popular in India. Almost all the good brands are selling high quality carbon bikes in India. And they are also selling it on a reasonable prices these days. So carbon frame bicycles are popular. Not as popular as steel bicycle, because the steel and other bicycles have been over the ages. There are millions of cycles available. Compared to that number, as carbon bicycles may not be less in number, but then people will choose for that. It all depends upon people's pocket, wallet, and their kind of use. Right? And Abhijit Mahatre, how to care for derailleurs like servicing or maintenance? We always recommend you to do the services in a trained technician store who are trained by, there are many brands in the country who give training, very less brands do that. In this particular presentation, I would say one thing, we will not mention any brand. We will not recommend any particular model of bicycles, because that will all focus into some particular thing. Is that correct, Pradeep?
Yes. So
there is a question from Aditya. He's asking about a particular model of a bicycle from a particular brand. So that we will leave it out, because we will not recommend any, because there are lots of questions. Is this bicycle better than the other bicycle? I mean, people think, just like asking if Ford EcoSport better than the other brand, it all depends upon what. There are hundreds of brands of cars available, and people are buying different cars for various reasons. So that way you choose it. And if you look at the components, that's what we have told. Look at the components and the quality of the components, and the store which is selling it to you, will he give you a right technical support in bicycling? Then there you should go. So always Abhijit Mahatre, derailleur servicing and maintenance have to be done by a trained technician, and send it to them and make these things work. So I have quickly answered Aditya's answer also. Find a bicycle which is good for you, looking at the components and your wallet space. Arun Prithviraj, what can for Indian roads? That which you covered, Prithviraj.
Yeah, we have addressed, yeah.
Then Paras. First question, what is the difference between a pro and amateur rider associated with the reader as standard from my angle?
This one you can probably see the Shimano website. You can see the difference in components because this is primarily related to components. Say, for example, on the high-end range, the rear derailleur do comes with direct frame attachment, and whereas the basic comes with direct frame attachment. So, but the difference is the level of components. So you can check in the Shimano website and find the difference. And the hanger is specific to a frame.
So Gopesh Devnath, what is his name so that I communicate later for Chris? Maybe probably he's asking your name, Pradeep.
Okay, I may not be so much active on social media because as you know that I have a full-time job and I do ride to my work passionately because I live in Bangalore. So I find riding 1 hour plus is much faster than taking my car or going by other motorized modes. So
this one leads to other
yeah.
thing, Pradeep. So if anybody in this particular discussion want to communicate some question to us, what is
you, you can reach over the email which is mentioned in that, or you can reach the social media pages also through the website. You can drop your communication so that the team forward that queries to me so that they can come back with the responses.
Okay. And even brands, Fatehpal Singh Malhi says, even brands are using copy Shimano parts in their bicycle. Now, Fatehpal, the thing is, when we have good brand, there are hundreds of brands now. When we say brands, every name which comes on with a sticker on a bicycle frame can be a brand for everyone. For cycling community, brands are like good quality brands who are present all over the Europe and all over the world. There are the good quality brands don't use Shimano parts, which are copied. Those bicycle brands which use copy brands are not brands as such. So you have to be very careful in choosing what brand you look at. Don't look go for the beauty of the bicycle. That is where your local bike store specialist will help you. So always, always talk to them before you buy a bicycle. Yeah. And take time before you buy a bicycle.
And maybe, Shazil, I want to add one more point here. As we discussed in the initial session itself, like Shimano is the leading market dominant player. Like Shimano commands about 80% of the market share in the bicycle industry across the world. So when such a brand is there, they need not explicitly drop their wordings across frame to represent their brand. So one of the key factor when you choose cycle is like, most of the time you might have seen like the word Shimano is written in bold across the frame and various other places other than the part. So that may be an indication for the buyer to know whether it's a real Shimano or not Shimano. Because if it's a real Shimano is, as a brand is so powerful that they need not explicitly write anywhere to mention that they need to brand or they need to put an ad. Probably that's one reason you won't find any marketing ads from Shimano, or probably they don't even publish any ad. Whereas when you buy a bicycle, some of the, if the components has some gaps, then you can find that the component name is written explicitly in bolder across the frame. That's one key identifier. Probably you as a buyer or as a consumer can look to identify the presence of real Shimano or non-Shimano.
That's correct. That is an overkill when people write big Shimano parts and Shimano fitted components. That itself is your red flag to see that people, their bicycle is not worth it. They are only living with the name of Shimano in it. So that kind of thing, you can easily avoid it.
And another thing is like, if you want to legally use the word Shimano, there is a copyright ownership and license fee which need to be paid to Shimano. So no real brand would allow to pay another set of money to Shimano to just to use the word across the frame.
So you know that India is a country where no copyright values are anyways valued. So you have to be very careful. Now Gopesh Devnath has a last question. I think there's one more question, but which brands in Pomoli do butter tubes is available in India? Now it's already again all mentioning about a brand. And please try target section road bike specially. Thank you so much for amazing question.
I think we can take that the brands question also. I mean, like we are not addressing the brand part. We are addressing only the chromoly tubing part. You need to see the tubing specifications because, as you know, that in India chromoly tubings are not manufactured. Chromoly tubings are manufactured, but it's for heavy industry use. That's the kind of pipeline that you use for water transportation or gas transportation, that kind of big pipelines. The normally the chromoly tubes in India are imported from Korea or China or Taiwan, or if you look for a premium brands, it's from the Europe. So it's typically on what kind of bike you want to build, because nowadays there are people who design their own frame, buy tubes and build it. So it's all depends upon how technically you are skilled. Like if you are a good welding person, probably you could cut tubings and you can make your own bike, provided the materials are available.
Yeah, and then there are international standard chromoly frames sold by companies who some other brands use it for their own branding. So you need to learn a little bit more about it. And to tell you, friends, Pradeep is an expert in chromoly sourcing. So you might want to talk to him too if you are looking for a customized bicycle frame, and he will give you suggestions on it. So looking at it, our participants are signing off because it's already 11 o'clock. Pradeep, so can we wind this session down?
And sure. Thank
you very much, friends who has participated in it. Madhav have, so there are somebody who is flagging their hands. Pradeep, what is, can you just check why people are flagging?
Yeah, Madhav, can you help to type the question? Because it would be good if you can type the question so that the answers are available to all. Because if we put audio enabling for all participants, there may be some balances in the bridge. So you can type your questions.
I'm sorry that we could not hear you. You have lots of questions to ask. And what happens, you know, it will be like 25 people asking questions. We can't control it. So this is how we have made it. And it's our humble effort to put a webinar. And we are trying our skills to share it with you. So I think we will wind it up in another 1 minute, right, Pradeep?
Yeah.
So let us sign it off. Do you want to quickly run that presentation slides quickly so that you can memorize it? So what we are doing now is all the presentation slides which we have done to you, we will, without speaking, we will run it from first to the last so that you can see and you can memorize it. And after that, we will wind it off. Okay, Pradeep?
Yeah. And thank you all for joining the webinar. And I'm just sharing the screen.
Sharing the screen once again. And then after that, we sign off. We will give you more in links for participating in the next
one. Yeah. So and thank you all for joining the webinar. We will be sharing a email which we need your feedbacks. So please do provide your feedbacks on what you like to hear and what you like to convey us on the webinar content, so that we can come with more informative contents to you.
So, going on, so please have a look at it, and then we will sign off.
Helping that we will also include this Shimano web page link in the feedback form so that you can open it and see more about this. Thank you. Thank you all for joining.
Thank you very much. Webinar. Thank you, Pradeep. Yeah, thank you. Thank you. Meeting. Thank you.
Thank you.